Let's do this. Let me know how the Mel, before we start, can you test your mic audio? Check, check.
Check, double check. My name's Mel. I have a bell.
Let's do this. Let me turn the game audio. I think the game audio should be fine. Let's open the stream. I mean, it's still crackling, but I don't think we can. Yeah, it's bearable. I'm not restarting. Anyways, let's get all the stuff set up. And the first car out is kind of genie. So, you know what? We missed a lot of time. I'm sorry that we're late, but when you have to set up a lobby instead of commentating, it's a bit more work to do. And I'm definitely gonna fucking delegate this shit because I should not be the one doing this. Should never be the one doing this. But we're here. I might as well intro the track now as you watch Genie's lap. We are here at one of the best tracks in the world. The magnificent Spa-Francorchamps, the Belgian Grand Prix, 19 corners, 10 to the left and 9 to the right, 7.004 kilometers. And if you're American like me, that's 4.352 miles. It is the longest track on both the F1 and URFL calendar. 22 laps, but first, as you can see, an 18-minute quali session as Genie crosses the line. Now, I am joined here by the great Mel Wiesma, Murray Walker Award winner. How you doing, mate?
Yeah, hello. Thanks for the welcome. I'm doing good. I'm happy to be here. Looking to be a very interesting race with, I would say, a lot of drivers wanting to win today.
Yeah, I mean, it'll definitely be interesting to see as Genie is on his lap now. It's the game audio is very loud for me. I don't think it is for the stream. Hopefully, I'm gonna make sure to log into the right account on Twitch. But as we look at that, Genie
AMD
has
King
started.
5 asks in the chat if he has a quality ban.
Yes, he does,
Okay.
and he knows it. So he retired already. It's fine.
Okay, my apologies
Race
then.
3, he's got a quality ban. Race 3, he's got a quality ban. So, interesting, very interesting. Edit stream info. Oh, live from. Hold on. Edit
Purple
stream
sector
info.
one
I've
for
quit.
goal.
Oh, really? Where is Ghoul? He's back there. So, yeah. So, you watch Genie. Let me put the lap data up. Because that is not. Actually, it is, but higher. And yeah, hopefully we can see something we'll do here. F1 2021. I hate that Twitch just notices that it's 2015 instead of 2021. Live from.
Yeah, it's weird. I believe it's been like this for almost a year now, and they still haven't changed it. This Genie finishes his lap with 144.618.
Yes, he has indeed.
It's only a tenth of my F1 22K1 qualifying time. Oh, Charlie,
It's Charlie on the
143.6.
mediums. That's a beautiful lap of 43.674. What kind of lap is Ghoul gonna do? Let's go down to Ghoul now. He's up to the line now. It should be personable. It is by 6 tenths. That tire delta's gonna be huge, especially with those mediums. They're just not gonna be it. I wonder though if the strat is because if you start on the softs, do you have to do a two stop? I don't race 21 anymore. I don't think you do either, Mel. So we're both left in the dark here.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see the
Ooh,
tire
I wonder if there's
strategies in
gonna be
this race.
rain. No Tokyo Drift Welshie this week. You're right, Welshie. We have no entertainment if it gets boring. As we see, who was that on the side of the road? Someone was on the side of the road. Who was that? It was an
Williams,
Alpha.
maybe?
It might have been just outside the pits. Just saw someone on the side of the road. As you look at the Alphas. They're towing each other. Yeah. Exarch Ghoul's getting a tow from his teammate Impulse Neo. This is beautiful from the Alpha drivers. Blake MC, currently in the Red Bull, will be very happy. There's a good reason for that Neo get out of the way. As Exarch Ghoul is going to go purple sector one, of course. Could this be a provisional pole lap if he holds it the rest together? But he's also got the dirty air in front from Exarch KSI Renegade, who gets out of the way. Watching the protege Sylph. Ooh, Sylph. Still obviously in the pits right now. That is my tier. That was my predicted tier 3 champion as Insanity. Ghost P2. 11,000's down. Insanity also back from the operation. Thankfully, it did go
Ooh.
well. And he is here as Ellie has left the session. Let me. That is actually Kitten. So I gotta remember to fix that. View profile. Add friend. Invite to game.
A lot of
Invite
yellow
to game.
flags.
Yeah, long track here at Spa. I mean, I don't know if you saw Mel, but yesterday there was an incredible quality block of a where there was a queue of drivers in Sector 2 that blocked Joshi. Actually, I think you were part of that. I didn't realize that when I was talking about it. But yeah, I mean,
Yeah. You
you
mean
wouldn't
at
think
the
there's a lot of track
last
here.
stages of the qualifying?
Yes.
Yeah, I believe yeah, I don't know what was going on. There were three two cars driving slowly in front of me. I overtook both of them and then they started speeding up as well. I'm not really aware of what happened
Yeah,
there.
it's
But I can
weird
understand that
situation
it's
for sure.
not visible for Jossie.
It's a weird situation for sure, and most of the stewards made it sort of. X-Ray School only went P6. I'm very surprised with that. Considering he got the tow, he's also 9/10 off, and someone who has not raced in about. He's not touched a controller, I think, in about 6 weeks is Blake MC. He goes P6. Ahead of X-Ray School, who had a tow. So that's interesting here. Does Blake have some pace that he's left over? And I guess that just show how easy the 21 game is? Just to pick it up and be decent? Compared to
I think
22, I guess.
it is easier to pick up than 22.
Oh yeah, for sure. As Croc is getting a tow from Ghoul, but Croc is also invalidated. Big whoop for Croc. Yeah,
I'm
he's having a bad lap.
currently watching Joshy Boy, who's on the lap as well, and he's looking decent.
Right. Joshi. I mean, let's see what kind of lap he can do here. I mean, that's right on. Let's just look at this. I mean,
Beautiful to see how he places the car
yeah,
exactly
for
on the
sure.
limit.
Going round here into the bus stop chicane now. Beautiful, fast left-hander. Iconic. Max Verstappen made an overtake around the outside there. I think we all remember that one. Balls of absolute steel here. As Josh turns it very early, using a
Ooh.
big snap on exit. He's gonna go up to the line now. DRS wide open. And he goes provisional pole into the
Let's go,
42-8.
Jossie! Let's
Mel, very excited with that one. That is, I think, only a tenth off the 22 tier 1 pole. So it's a very nice lap.
I thought the F122 cars would be faster around this track due to the long straights.
Yeah. Long straights and then the fast corners as well. But I
Indeed.
guess the slow corners really slow them down. Thankfully, the tool is working as well, so we will have some nice stats for qualifying at least. I have no idea if we'll get some nice stats for race because it likes being glitchy with a Mac. As we see Kairazu off the track in the grass. Not the first time we're gonna see a Ferrari in the off the track. We love the pain. Oh wow, MC Explorer, big moment there as he starts his lap. Now, Sylph on a lap, I believe. Long sector 2. Just using everything possible. Not using the esports lad though. Very interesting as Kitten's still in the box. I'm guessing he only wants the one lap. See, Sylph's still on his lap. No, I don't know if many people are on laps per se. Is MC Explorer.
Oh no, Sylph lost
He's
it.
gone in Rouge and Sylph is. Yeah, you're right. Sylph has spun. And now let's head to Eau Rouge. What's happened? What's happened? We need to know. He's killed himself in the. I don't know if that's the right word, but Eau Rouge has not been too kind to him. Let's ride on board with the Red Bull of Charlie Arc. Maybe the Williams is still there. We can see it. I think it's the rear wheel. That's what it looked like, because the rear was more towards the wall. If we look here, I could not get a snapshot of that, but I think it's the rear right.
I think so as well.
That's a shame for Williams there. Well, she will not be happy as Sylph now heads back in the box. So both drivers making mistakes while out. Vipstar on his out lap now, and see what he can do. Shaney, back in the Haas, he's a 10th up now.
Charlie's also on a lap.
8 tenths. Yes, you're right, Charlie is on a lap, and we saw that, so I should definitely stay with him here. Charlie, a beautiful through Puan. I think he's being cautious through there. I don't know whether that's aggressive or cautious, but he's using a lot of curb on the entrance. Just attacking it now. This is nice to see, isn't it?
It is awesome to see. Already 9 tenths up.
Sector 2. Yeah.
Fuck.
On that medium lap. So this would be provisional pole.
Yeah.
Yeah, it would be a 42.7. So let's see if he can hold on. Not much time to lose here in this third sector. But if you do mess up, it can definitely... It doesn't wash out as much, actually, as well. It's breaking down at about 80 meters. Wow, the braking power in an F1 car is incredible. Here as we head into the final corner. DRS flies wide open. What is this lap going to be? Provisional pole. Wow. That is quicker than the 22 turn one time. For sure.
It is a very fast time indeed.
Yeah, hoping the yellow flags can go away so we can see the amount of time left in quality. 6 minutes and 10 seconds left in qualifying.
Only 6 tenths here left in qualifying. My apologies.
Perez, a Ferrari, Kairazu without a front wing. No jokes here. I think we just let that pain soak in. Genie on a lap now, about a tenth down, goes a bit wide, has to lift on exit. And that's going to definitely compromise his run all the way into the bus stop chicane. And I don't think he's going to be able to do anything with this lap. Anyone to watch as of right now, Mel?
Maybe a Lotharunner on a lap. Oh, no, he's invalidated. My apologies.
Yeah. Kittens is also on a lap. Or on an out lap.
Kitten would definitely be one to watch.
Ooh, sure. Insanity's on a lap. Insanity is on a lap. What will we see from the
so many fast people
himself?
To look at?
It's awesome heading up to the line. Now this is a 42.7 and it's P2. Big lap from Insanity, but unfortunately not pole. He does have enough time to get around and go for another. I think this is going to be one run and done for Kitten as he heads up to the line. We'll ride on board with him for this entire lap. We'll just have this and you can watch this lap.
The goal is now up in P2 again.
Good lap from Ghoul. What did he do? A 42?
Yeah, 42.737.
It's a beautiful one. Kitten now taking all the curb he can. It's a beautiful line through Eau Rouge. Now, ODRS flies wide open as we head down the Camel Straight. He's trying to scrub off as little speed as possible as we head into Lecombe. And now, Kitten, what can he do? The championship leader. This is a huge qualifying lap. Huge ramifications for this championship. Bit wide, he absolutely misses the apex on entrance. I don't know if that's the line, but it doesn't look like it. He's really looks like a lot of understeer now. As Roadrunner has left the session, Mel, if you could get that man back in, that's got to be an invalidation.
Yes, so
surely, yes, it is. And let's get Roadrunner back in. Maybe his Xbox died because he just went offline.
Yeah, I believe he'll be in a party that. AMG anyways.
Yeah, I think so. Kitten now will have the tough decision. Do you box for a new set of tires, or do you have enough fuel, go for another one? I think here, if you're Kitten, I think you gotta box for a new set. I don't know if he has the fuel. It says 2.4 on the dash is what his fuel is at, so he does have enough for another lap and an in lap if need be, so I wouldn't be surprised if he goes for another one here. But the tires, I don't know if they'll be the best thing to do. Let's see what he does. He goes very wide there. He is for another lap. Wow. Saw that as well.
Yes.
That's a big moment there for the championship leader. What can he do? Trying to pick up the throttle as early as possible now. The tires will be screaming a bit. Maybe a double outlap was the move. For Kitten, I don't think it will be, as the tires wear very quickly here. I believe that was easy flat through Eau Rouge. DRS wide open, trying to scrub as little speed off as possible. And this is going to be beautiful as we head into Lecombe one more time. Kitten using all the entrance curb he can. Let's see if he can hit an apex this time. He does. But a bigger, much bigger lift, though. I don't know if that'll be up on his time. As we head, just hugging the curb there. He goes a bit wide, but then brings it back in. Now as we head into the famous Puan now. Beautiful. Ooh, just a bit of a moment there. As now we head into Puan. How aggressive is he going to be? Not too bad. Didn't need all the curb on the exit. And now, yellow flags out in sector 2. Sector 3 now, as Ghoul cross, as I believe that's an AlphaTauri. Now heading to start his lap now. Kitten, what are we going to see? A 1:14.750. It's saying purple sector 2 on the mini-map. And Kitten now heading into the bus stop chicane. This is going to be incredible from Kitten, the championship leader. What can he do to try and secure that place at the top of the championship? A 42.6, still pole position as of right now. Can we see provisional pole lap from Kitten? Will this go on the YouTube for a beautiful pole lap for Kitten? He's going to head up to the line now through the bus stop chicane beautifully. DRS wide open, and it is a 43.1. Where was the time lost?
Wow. It's
a lot of guys on outlaps now. And suddenly, Josh is going to be the first to cross the line. Out of that top five. So Kitten's qualifying is over. No, he's going for it again. There's no way he has the ERS or the fuel. But this is going to be interesting. Kitten's going for it again. Those tires, there's no way they're going to be hanging on. Is Josh now starting his lap? With Insanity right ahead of Vivstar, who's only set a 2:22.5. That'll be interesting to see for the McLaren driver. There's no way Oka will be happy with that. As of right now, is Joshy starting his lap.
It's quite interesting to see that the Ghoul 17 has decided to stay in.
Yeah, it's very interesting. Maybe he doesn't think he can get any more out of the lap. Wants to save the tires. Maybe he goes for a medium soft. I mean, I can only imagine there will be a safety car here today.
Yeah.
So, suddenly approaching the line. You can see the queue in Sector 3. Mel, how's that going? You see that queue in Sector 3. It's like Q1, as people are jumping the queue as well. Vivstar now starting his lap. Williams in front of him. Look, Schultz had to let people go. I don't think he has the fuel. I can't tell because the Williams dash is so small. Is Charlie starting his lap? No! Qualifying over! Charlie will not get a lap!
Oh.
And Joshy's invalidated! So this is Insanity's pole to lose. Kitten's a tenth and a half up. This would not give him anything more than P5. But we could see Kitten maybe set off a huge lap here. Can he get into the top four? This would be huge. Kitten out to the line. It is a 43.0. So now we're just looking at
Insanity.
He's invalidated. Pole position for Charlie. Unless Neo has anything to say about it, he's 5/10 up. 5/10 up. As of right now, he would go P5. This would be huge. Neo needs to hold on to this. Can Neo maybe snatch away a pole position? Renegade's on an outlap, this won't matter. Genie on a lap now. Let's stay with Neo here. Heading into the final corner.
Insanity retired on track.
Insanity invalidated, so it doesn't... I don't know if it matters or not. Maybe it'll impede someone. 42.9! He stays P6. No, he goes P5. It said P6 still. P5 for Neo. Huge for the Alfa Romeo driver. Genie, 200s up, has now turned to 700s up. This would bring him not ahead of Renegade, so he needs a great Sector 3. XRX Ghoul has moved up into P9. It's into the top 10 for him. Croc, still P10. Blake invalidated. His qualifying's over. Vivstar, I believe, is on a lap as well, as Vivstar's heading into the final corner. Let's go to Vivstar now. Vivstar, 21 seconds up on a 2:22 lap, so this is not going to be anything. Okay, this game is bugged. 43.0 for Vivstar. It's a beautiful lap. Genie up to the line. It's only a 43.704. I don't think he improved. So it'll be Renegade holding the P8, but Vivstar P7, and it's pole position for Charlie Arc. Oh, 4. What a comeback for the Red Bull driver. I need water.
A very impressive comeback. Yeah, he got go by almost more than a 10th.
It's a huge gap for qualifying. Ooh, a top five all in the 42s, with Kitten barely getting in those 43s. Missing those 42s. And Vivstar only 300s away from the championship leader in Kitten. That is Ellie Vibes, but that is Kitten, I assure you.
I think it's bugged out because it says that It's Renegade is an outlier.
So when he it says 18 seconds left, so I think it'll go for another 30 because it's bugged, and then we'll go to race trim. Speaking of race trim, it'll be very interesting. We don't have a formation lap, so I can't really intro all this. So I'll try to get it out as quickly as I can. Mel, did you know that the 12 of the last 22 Belgian Grand Prix have been won by less than 5 seconds?
Ooh, no, I did not know that. It's
very interesting.
What are you going to say? My apologies.
No, it's fine. I was just going to say it's going to be very interesting to see. I was going to say, obviously not the 2022 race where Verstappen won from P14 and made that one a boring one. But yeah, what were you going to say?
I think it is a track that invites racing a lot of side-by-side. So that could be very interesting.
What? Renegade just warped from the finish line to sector 2. I'm going to take a screenshot of the results as of right now, just in case we need to restart. Is the lobby bugged? Let's look at the discard. I think it's going to be a restart. It's going to have to be a restart now.
Yeah, I think so. I think that's the smartest thing to do.
We're going to have to red flag. Yeah, we're going to have to red flag. What was the dry weather for a race? What was the weather for race?
I have no clue. I cannot see that from my commentating position.
I'm enough to make it.
It's gonna be.
Let's go. Renegade left.
Okay.
So now we go to race. Let's invite Renegade back in. Where's Renegade? There he is.
Wow, top 7 within half a second of each other, and then a gap from almost 6 tenths to the guy in P8.
Yeah, that's incredible, isn't it? I'm just on a black screen, so I cannot list the grid. If you can see the grid, could you go through it for us, please?
Charlie Harkin and Red Bull in P1, we got Ghoul in P2, we got Insanity in P3, we got Joshua in P4, in P5 we got Impulse Neo, in P6 we got Ellie 5, Farmageddon, in P7 is Fifstar, in P8 is Renegade, in P9 is Giri, in P10 is Ghoul, in P11 is Croc, in P12 we got Blake, in P13 we got Carassus like DJ, in P14, and oh my god, that was too slow.
Where'd you leave off P14?
P14 is where I stopped, yes.
So let's go to the race director. Do you want to finish it or should I?
Yeah, you can finish it.
So P14, as you said, Sly DJ. P15, Roadrunner. I don't know if he's back in the lobby, but he is starting P15. P16, Shaney on the mediums as the lobby has started. Thank you for whoever did that. White Shroot in P17, Sylph P18. AMG P19 and P20 is MC Explorer. So AMG obviously with the quality ban, but I'm guessing MC Explorer did something, did DNF'd himself, so it just, I don't know. I actually don't know how that works. Roadrunner, so we'll see. I don't know if Roadrunner's back in the lobby, but we're only seeing two medium runners starting, is Kairazu and White Shroot. Let's go back to the grid now, as we see we're going to start the Belgian Grand Prix. Let's go. It's 3, 4, 5 red lights now. And what can we see here? We're underway here in Belgium. It's a good start, I believe, from Renegade. I think it's his AI. Anyway, Charlie into the lead at turn one. Ghoul's going to go for it around the outside. Can he get it done? No. Insanity's trying it down the inside. And Joshy's around the outside. We see yellow flags out. There's a stall on the grid. It's MC Explorer. He's not in the lobby. And now, Charlie Arc. MC Explorer's been disqualified. Charlie Arc is going for it. He's in the lead now. Ghoul right behind. But here comes Insanity. He's going to go for it. Down the inside. Can he get it done? Ghoul's going to cover it off. Ghoul maybe going to get a move down the inside. No. Insanity's on the outside. Can he get it done? Oh, what a move.
What?
He couldn't hold it.
Damn.
He's going to hold it on the inside. It's a beautiful move. Josh is going to have to sit back. Ellie Vibbs now. Oh, this is beautiful. Charlie's running away with it now. Ghoul, 8 tenths up to Charlie, 9 tenths now. Insanity trying anything he can to get past. Ghoul does not look like to have the pace. Charlie is flying.
Damn.
Wow.
as Insanity goes a bit wide, you see there, predicted pit stop strategy, soft medium, so I was wrong when saying that there would be a two-stop. It looks like it's going to be an easy one-stop here. Vivstar has gotten past Kitten as well. So this is huge. Let's get some of this stuff up. Position changes. As of right now, AMG King 5 up 5 position. He's the biggest gainer off the start. We'll keep the tires up. Guys, look at this. Beautiful. Let's see if we can get a helicopter shot. Please? 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 No? No. It doesn't want to bless us with a helicopter shot. No.
Yeah, it's sad.
And Sanity, 3/10 back. Now, Ghoul has not lost as much time as we thought. He's still 7/8 back. He's losing a lot of time on exit. Charlie obviously sets the fastest lap of the race. Now, XR's Ghoul has gone past Neo. So it looks like Neo just let his teammate through. Oh wow, XR school goes deep, and Neo will take the position right back. Two teammates battling it out with their TP right behind. It's an interesting situation, not one I've ever seen, as Genie right behind, 1 second back, and Sanity 3/10 back. It looks like this will just even out. As the other guys do not want to be using their E-Rest. Yellow flags, XR school, what happened?
He went just straight on into the wall. It was very weird. Very
and Kairazu now with no front wing. It's like DJ has a 5 second penalty for a severe collision with White True. It's a virtual safety car out now. And Kairazu, it's another moment for the Ferrari driver. And the Ferrari TP at that. I'm not going to make a joke about Ferrari, but I think they write themselves, don't they?
They definitely do.
As Kairazu will have to box for a new front wing and new tires as well. I believe he'll go maybe for another set of the mediums.
Yeah, I've got to
take the sauce, actually.
Quick look at the race director to see if that gave me any.
As green flags, out and racing again. Roadrunner still not in the lobby. I don't think he will be, so he will receive a DSQ if he does not join back. As we're open back the chat and
that was it. Chaotic.
So let's.
Second lap?
Yeah, it was very chaotic. Second lap here.
AMG, though, gained 7 positions.
Yeah, beautiful for AMG, wow. Carrazo's still only 10 seconds back. It's not bad for someone without a wing.
But he.
As Insanity. He did have the box, yeah.
He started on the medium compound tires, so he has to go to the hard compound tires, Carrazo.
Yeah, surely he has to. Maybe he can go from the hards, and if there's another safety car, maybe he can go back to the mediums. That would be a good strategy for him. So we'll see what can happen there, as Kairazu's gonna box now. Sly DJ also in as well. I believe he has front wing damage because of his collision with White Shrew. So that's huge, as Charlie still leads from Ghoul, Insanity, from Joshi, Vivstar, still ahead of Kitten. As Kairazu gets a 5 second penalty for speeding in the pit lane, that's a shame for the Ferrari TP. Attended Genie P7. Neo P8, Blake MC moving up into P9 with Croc going for it down the inside. Croc gonna easily get that one done with the DRS and late braking here. Blake down in the P10, Renegade trying anything he can, and Blake trying to get a move back. He's gonna tap Croc a little bit, and he's gonna lose a lot of time. Renegade's in a game, go for it into the corner. Blake gonna have to let him through. Maybe a switchback here for the Red Bull driver. No, AMG also just sitting behind, biding his time, trying to get something done. But obviously, as that changes, Croc P9. Oh wow, 3 second time penalty for the Alpha TB. That's a shame for him, but he obviously hasn't raced in a while, so I assume he's not used to this. Does he have wing damage? No, he doesn't, so I'm guessing he just has a maybe understeer setup. Is AMG gonna go for it? Down the inside goes AMG, and Blake just lets him through.
Maybe he does have damage. He already lost 3%. Oh,
Joshi! Joshi was saying about how he might take a win here. Maybe a second consecutive podium, but it's not gonna happen. It's not gonna happen. I don't know if he has wing damage. We're gonna have to look. He does not. Does it as it looks?
Not anyway.
So Joshi now is falling way back. Oh, Kairazu. DNF. Could be something here. We're not gonna see anything yet. I'm looking at the pit lane. Fastest lap for Charlie Arc. Doesn't look like there's gonna be anything. As Charlie's still holding on. Vivstar up into P4, obviously with the Joshi spin. As we see Blake is boxing. Yeah, he definitely has front wing damage. That's a shame for Blake MC. That is a shame.
Yeah, but it's Kairazu out. Looked like he went straight on at the hairpin into a wall.
Ah, and we'll see. Maybe we get a report about it. Who knows? Blake onto the hard compound tires. Charlie Arc,
oh,
sorry.
Oh, no, Neo!
I've lost
Neo.
The lead. What happened
oh,
to Neo?
No.
He's falling back. He's falling way back.
I think
oh, Rouge,
he's
does he
spun.
Have a moment as Renegade going past Krillo Croc. That's a shame. As Vibs, sorry, not Vibs. Flashbacks to last two seasons ago. As Ellie Vibs, I said it again, former kitten, sorry, ahead of Vibstar. And Charlie has gotten passed by Ghoul. So Ghoul used the DRS on the Camel Strike.
Neo
what happened
has damage
happened
as well.
Neo? Oh, wow, Blake. I believe, does Neo have damage? That'd
yeah,
be huge.
Yes. Front wing.
Oh, yeah, front left end plate.
Yes, that one.
That's a shame for Neo. It qualified P5. Blake MC, I believe, trying to warm his tires. Yeah, I don't think the hards are feeling too good for him. He had a moment up at Rouge. I don't know if he has damage. So right now, we have 16 eligible drivers to score points, as Roadrunner will receive a DSQ for being in AI for more than 5 laps.
Oh, yellow flag.
Hazard genuinely crashed, apparently. Yellow flag again.
Oh, no,
that's Joshy.
Joshy boy.
Joshy, again.
I
he has
I
all
saw
his front wing bits.
Okay.
I don't know, though, Mel. It just looked like from a glance that he had all his front wing bits.
Yeah, he did have all of his front wing bits.
As Ghoul takes the fastest lap, Slide DJ gets a 3-second time penalty, but let's go back to the battle for the lead. Charlie Arc looking for to get a switch back now. He's right behind Ghoul, almost in his gearbox, and insanely lying in wait. Kitten biding his time, trying to do anything he can. And Charlie's going to get the dirty air up Eau Rouge. There's going to have to be a slight lift. Oh, he offsets himself nicely through Eau Rouge, and this is going to be an easy move for him. But Insanity's right behind, and this is going to be huge. Insanity's gaining. He's gaining as Charlie gains. Insanity is going to go for it. Maybe up the inside. No, around the outside. Can he get it done? Under braking. Ghoul's going to try and hold on. Ghoul.
Oh!
Oh, that's all on Ghoul. That's on Ghoul. That is fully on Ghoul. He didn't leave Insanity the space. And now Charlie can romp away now. Ghoul, 1.7 seconds back on Insanity. And Vivstar only gaining with this. And Vivstar's also overtaken. Kitten, there's a yellow flag. Yellow flags. Joshy's in. What am I looking for?
Genie.
Kairazu? Genie. Yeah, you're right. What's happened? We need to know!
I'm not sure what happened there.
He still looks like to have all his front wing.
Is it?
It's a big train right now.
Yeah, is it Stroot making his debut today?
Yes, you're right, he is making his debut. Me and Mel both know about Stroot from Open Lobbies. He is fairly decent on 22. I don't know about his 21 pace, but he's looking pretty nicely. But that's
yeah.
A shame for Kairazu, who apparently genuinely crashed. Going into the hairpin, so that's again the Ferrari TP having struggles, and I have to feel for him. He was looking to be the favorite for the Tier 2 championship, Tier 4 championship last season, and it just didn't work out. It really didn't work out, and it's a shame for him. His Insanity is trying to fight against the DRS of Charlie Arc as Joshy gets the 3-second time penalty, and Ghoul 17 has fallen back 3 seconds now to Insanity. Did he maybe get damage? There's surely not. Because it was rear wheel to front wheel.
I don't think he has damage. Maybe a little bit overheated tires.
Yeah.
A cracked ego.
Maybe. Talent. Damage talent. As Vibstar now is going to have the DRS along with Kitten. And I will say, shout out to Killer Croc, P6 right now. He's doing another beautiful job with AMG closing in. Lap after lap after lap. White Shroot still holding this DRS train like he's Alexander Albon. As Renegade's in. New front wing. It's a shame for the Alpine TP as Neo may overtake him. Neo looks to have a lot of understeer on those hard compound tires as Joshy's on the mediums. Renegade has been released from his pit box. This will be a race here. I'm not seeing any too close battles, so we'll stay on board with this. Renegade's going to come out of the pits now. He will come out ahead of Neo, but Neo will have the DRS surely. 1.2 is the gap, 1.2 is the gap, 1.0, 1.035, 1.018. I don't think he got it. I don't think he got the DRS, and neither did Joshy. And Renegade goes very wide there. He does not have the DRS. So, we'll see what Neo can do, maybe chase down Renegade, but Renegade is also in the medium compound tires. So we'll have to worry about Joshy behind, and obviously Blake on the hard. Yellow flags, white shoot,
no.
Exit of Puon. He was doing so well, 6 laps into his first URFL race, and that's a shame for him. I believe this is actually his second URFL race. I think he did a 22 race yesterday. So his first debut for 21. So still a debut, as you said. Silt up in PA, that's a beautiful for the Williams driver, trying to carry the Williams up. As AMG, King 5 up into P7 still, he's 1.2 seconds back behind Croc, who's having a moment again. The oversteer really hindering Croc a lot on these 21 cars. I'm seeing a lot of oversteer from him, just in general. with MG gaining even more. Kitten, still 5 tenths back. Vivstar, 5 tenths back from the Ghoul 17.
It looks like Kitten maybe is a little bit stuck behind Vivstar and the Ghoul. But as I say that, he immediately gets get. Ghoul now goes for the overtake. What? I mean, Vivstar? What? I thought I saw Ghoul go side by side. My apologies. Yellow flag in sector 1. Is that Blake? Ooh. Those were Sylph and Shroot, I believe. Pistar is now driving away from the Ghoul, it looks like. Yeah. Ooh, another 3 second time penalty for Blake. It's his second 3 second time penalty of the day. Oh, Insanity is in, Fifth Star's in. I would say that's early. Who knows? Ooh, as MG King 5 now moves up into P4. Leafy now has gained 50 places since the start of the race. Even though it is at least 3 positions because of a pit stop, it's still very impressive.
I've realized I've been muted this entire time, so that's a good one. 15 positions, as you said. Insanity, I think the general rule of thumb is if the longer the track, the better the undercut is. So the undercut will be huge for Insanity. So I think he will get it on Charlie. I genuinely think he will come out ahead of Charlie Art. And Charlie, I think if he gets a safety car now, well, one. If he gets a safety car right now, I think he stays P1. I think Kitten and the Ghoul will come out ahead of Insanity if they get a safety car right now. So looking back at the back of the pack, you want to give us some interesting racing, maybe some little shake-up. Safety car, please.
Oh.
No, whoa. I haven't done that. No, I haven't whoa. Done that. No, please don't be a safety car. Blake is retired. That's a shame for Blake. That's a shame. Please don't be a safety car. I didn't mean it. It's not a safety car. Mel, see, it's fine.
It's fine. I didn't mean it.
So there is no. It, so it didn't happen.
There's no system.
No, there is none. No
system. It was
Thank
perfect.
God,
timing.
There was. Oh, Charlie hits the wall on the entrance to the pit lane. Very light tap though, when he had a moment. So maybe that will factor in as Kitten's also in. The Ghoul following him in. AMG, will he stay out? Or will he take the lead of the Grand Prix? Yes, he will. He will take the lead of the Grand Prix. So he's hoping for a safety car now. Blake, I'm very sorry. I don't think I commentators cursed you because I asked for a safety car and not for a specific DNF. Did I ask for a specific DNF?
No.
I don't remember. Okay, good. Sadly, not going to come out ahead of Charlie. Charlie's going to hold on to the lead, but AMG's going to be right alongside of him. Oh, AMG's going to go for it. Into Eau Rouge. Charlie's going to let him through. But AMG's going to get the DRS. This is huge.
Whoa!
Oh, AMG, what a save. We saw his saves in Monaco. But yeah, Charlie will not get the DRS. The DRS detection point way before. Charlie's trying to warm his tires a little bit. Insanity's going to get a huge undercut now because Charlie's going to be stuck behind AMG now. And now Charlie's going to definitely be regretting letting AMG through because Insanity's going to be right on his tail with DRS. Insanity having a bit of a moment there. Oh, this is huge for the championship. This is huge for this race. Oh, look how much grip more Charlie has. Look how much more grip Charlie has as we head now into Puan. He's practically pushing him along. There's no way he goes for it into Puan, and AMG knows that. He goes a little bit defensive, but it's not going to matter. And Sanity's gaining all the time now, and Vivstar will as well. Maybe going for it down the inside. He's going to go for a dummy. What a move. He's going to go for it down the inside. He's going to hold it, but AMG going to hold it around the outside. Oh, he forces him wide. It's a bit of a tap. And then suddenly, Charlie's through. Charlie is through, and AMG surely will be in this lap. And suddenly, Bully won it down the inside. He's going to have to lift now. And AMG, big moment, he hits the wall. You saw his car take a hop. It's a hop, skip, and a jump away from a pit stop now for AMG. Hello, Harmless. Nice to see you here. I see yellow flags out. Yellow flags out. Right True? No, Renegade. Well, the Megaspin Award winner, as no front left end plate, hits the wall again. As AMG stays out yet another lap. Maybe he thinks safety car. No, there will not be. So I'm surprised as Shaney and Genie are going side by side now. Oh, it's a beautiful switchback from Shaney. Does he have the DRS? No, he does not. The Haas driver will have to wait for the next straight. I'm surprised these soft runners are really stretching these tires. I think we'll know what the... Oh, wow. This will be an easy move. And Stanley somehow got past Charlie. So I'm guessing there, as AMG's gonna go for it. Down the inside. He's going on the grass. He's got it done.
Whoa.
What a move. But he also went off track and now... Oh, yeah. Saw that coming. It's a shame as Vivstar now goes past. Kitten goes past. AMG now will have to box. That's a shame for AMG. I think he could have done it by keeping barely two wheels on the track, but he just went too far. Way too far. That's a shame for AMG. He was doing really well. But now he'll have to carve his way back through the field. As Shaney and Genie still fighting for it. Let's stay with this. As now Genie's going to get forced a bit wide. And now the Ghoul 17 on new tires is going to be arriving on the scene. As now, is Genie able to go for it? No, not in the Puan. Of course not in the Puan. But he goes a bit wide. And now Ghoul stuck a wheel up the inside. Now Ghoul's going to go for it. Down the... Oh, this is going to be a huge move. Oh, he's going to get boxed in. Now is Genie going to go for it? Shaney. Oh, this is huge. They're tapping a lot now.
Whoa.
They're tapping a lot even more. And Shaney, oh, that's a shame. But I think that's all on Shaney there. He was kind of a passenger there. He could have broke a little bit more, gone a bit slower. But asking a racing driver to go slower is like, I don't really know what the metaphor for that is, but...
It's not likely to happen.
Yeah, you're right. It's not likely to happen. So, Genie's still right behind. He's going to get the toe. Surely he should be in this lap. 10 laps on these meaty, soft compound tires. Ghoul's going to back out, I think. Expecting a box? No. Genie will stay out for another one.
Interesting.
So the Ghoul wants the DRS, I'm assuming, on the Camel Straight so he can pull away from these soft compound tires. You see AMG ahead. Yeah. 1 second. Sorry, but it looks like Kitten is going to go for it down the inside. It's going to be an easy move with DRS. And it's an Aston double podium as of right now. So Vivstar, what can he do? Maybe he can go for it down the inside? No, he's not going to.
Helicopter shot.
And sadly, still 1.2.
For me?
Where?
They fucking bad kid in a Vivstar. You didn't see it?
What?
Oh, no.
Favoritism.
Definitely. No, I'm sorry.
Ghoul 17 is fast. Attended Genie. It's a valiant effort from Genie, but he will definitely fall away now. Now it's Croc's job to get past. Be huge. Right now, Croc in a net P6. That's huge for the AlphaTauri TP, who almost had a podium last time out in Monaco. Just lost out because of a broken front wing that he had. There's Joshy Boy up in P9 now. Maybe he can claw back a P7, P6 maybe. He can get close enough. Sly DJ. Still P10. Not too much going on. I said 5 seconds for the last 12 Belgian Grand Prix, the gap between P2 and P1. Right now it's 1.2 seconds as Renegade gets 3 second time penalty, and I'm surprised that Henley's falling out of the DRS of Charlie, with Charlie being on those one lap fresher tires. I didn't think there'd be that much of a tire delta.
Yeah. That's interesting.
This are still fighting this one hard against Kitten. This will be a battle to the end as Kitten sets the fastest lap in the race at 45.758. I believe that's close to some people's qualifying times. Genie's in. So Genie's finally boxed.
I believe Insanity has a flashing light at the back of his car.
We will see now as he flies past. Yes, he does. And Charlie's ERS looks perfectly fine. So it looks like Charlie's just waiting maybe to recharge for a push. Here's Vivstar gets dangerously close to Kitten, but could not go for that move. Ghoul has flown past AMG, but AMG's gaining. He's gaining. Here comes AMG! Down the outside! Can he get it down the... Beautiful pulse hitter from Monaco. Can he get it down around the outside? He's done it once. Maybe flashbacks back to the Insanity incident. But he does not have the grip to be able to go alongside with Ghoul to stay with. As Ghoul will hold on. Now try to pull away from AMG on those 11 lap old softs. What are you drinking, man?
Some energy. My apologies. Oh,
very nice. Red Bull. You're drinking a Red Bull?
Yes.
Oh. Where do the loyalties lie?
Yeah.
You know who you're pulling for this race win. As you see, Insanity's getting too tense randomly, and there's a big moment. And Neo's gotten past Shroot as well. Oh, Shroot's... Oh, wow. What a save, first of all.
He kept it out of the wall?
Yeah, that is... Props to you, Shroot. Hasn't been the best race for you, but that is a good save. Nice to keep that one out of the wall. Just make sure you get the grass off the tires, let them cool down a bit, and you'll be fine. Renegade, down in P16. Looks like he's going to go for the soft compound tires now. Charlie still holds a 1.2 second gap. Vivstar still 8 tenths back. He's losing a lot of time. The only thing keeping Vivstar in this is the DRS. And Ghoul's gaining a lot on Vivstar. Can I get the last lap for Vivstar versus the last lap for Ghoul?
Yes, I'll
last two laps. Last 2 laps for Vivstar, last 2 laps for Ghoul, please.
Okay, last 2 laps of the Ghoul was a 146.7 and a 146.8. Vivstar was a 147. Flat and a 146.6.
Okay, so not too much gaining. Is Vivstar going to go for it down the inside? Easy move with DRS. He's flashing on DRS as well, so Kitten will definitely take that into account. But that means the Ghoul is not gaining as much as I thought he would be. And obviously, without DRS, he lost 7 tenths on the Kemmel straight. That's Croc now, 8 tenths back on AMG. So AMG's in an incredible stint. 12 laps on these soft compound tires on high fuel. Very good stint. Not as impressive as Ghoul's 30 lap. What was it, 36 lap?
Yeah, I believe so.
Medium stint? Yeah, something like that.
That was crazy.
Did you say some Hennessy, Mel? Harmless is asking if you're drinking some Hennessy right now.
No Hennessy.
if only. Probably spice things up a little bit.
More of a Saturday night thing.
Good point. Croc, still right behind AMG. Maybe he can get something done here. Neo, 9 tenths back on Sly DJ. Not too much. Oh, and Sandy's pulled with 6 tenths on Charlie, and Charlie's gonna have backmarker traffic. But I don't know if you call it backmarker traffic or help, because he now has DRS, and Insanity will be fuming now. Because the race leader now is DRS on the blue flag car in front, which is Renegade, who is on new softs, surely will pull away. And we have to remember, Renegade with nothing to lose is a Renegade that will cause a safety car.
You got a fair point there, Nova. Yeah.
So let's hope that, let's stay with Charlie, let's hope that we don't see a flying Alpine.
Nah.
Not a flying Dutchman, but a flying Alpine. We'll see what he can do. Is Vibs... Gotta stop that. That's
yellow flag, sector one.
Yellow flags. I think that's a BS yellow flags.
Yeah.
Killer Croc has just gone past AMG now. Who has the DRS, though? AMG does. So this is going to be an easy move. Croc's needed to wait. Because AMG's not going to get past 13 lap. I think AMG's waiting for a safety car. I don't know how he's taking those tires so long. Look at him. Look how much oversteer he's getting. Croc's practically pushing him along.
Whoa.
Oh, look at the defense. Rosberg-esque. Rosberg on Hamilton in Spain. Or Rosberg on Hamilton. Or Rosberg on Alonso when Alonso was crying about leaving the space. So we'll see. Maybe that can spark something up, but I think that's just hard racing.
Yeah, definitely was hard racing. Good to see you, so.
Croc. Yeah, Ghoul's also pull away a lot from AMG. Croc needs to really pick the right time to get an overtake done. He needs to do it on the Kemmel straight with DRS. Speaking of DRS, Insanity will have it, and Charlie will not, as Renegade is the fastest lap of the race. So now that he's gotten the fastest lap and he has the pride for it, again, Charlie goes really wide, so does Insanity. Insanity's followed him. Charlie just dipped a wheel on the grass. Maybe he was doing that on purpose to get the best run up Eau Rouge. Because now he's pulled... Wow, that's a lot of time he's pulled. I don't think that would have been the best run, because if he just hit the Apex, it would have been fine. Incinity's just chilling, I think. Maybe he's saving some ERS. So, let's hope Renegade.
Yellow flag sector 3.
I don't believe that, though. Why? I don't understand. So AMG's done it again. So AMG's playing Croc like a fiddle. Now Croc's trying to break the toe. Croc knows. Vivstar's also 3 tens back. But it won't matter. So it looks like, I don't know if Kitten got the move done or what happened. AMG having a big moment there. What a save. What a save again. AMG now going for it. He's going to empty the ERS now. He's got so much. 5 tens back. This will be a huge send from here. Can he get it done? No.
Not
in the valiant. I thought about it. The valiant defense of P6 from AMG is over. And Croc can now pull away. And now he's given a beautiful gap to Ghoul, who's also caught a second to Vipster from the last time we checked in on their pace. So AMG already a second back, and surely AMG will box now. AMG's gonna lose a lot of time. He'd box and he'd be out of the points. So
we'll
have to see. Maybe he's still hoping for a safety car. That's a huge stint on the soft compound tires.
I really don't think we're gonna see a safety car.
No, I don't.
AMG had a huge moment there.
Well, we had the safety car Maestro.
What did you say?
I don't think I said Maestro for some reason, which is teacher in Spanish, so I don't know why I said that. I meant the master of the safety car. So,
yeah.
It's a bit of a brain fart for me. What's master in Dutch?
Meester.
Meester? So the meester of the safety car.
Yes. Going.
Got a Red Bull in the lead. It's like real F1. Except... hopefully in Spa we see this. And Aston overtaking a Red Bull for the lead. Now it's Insanity going for it. Down the inside. Now it's going to be an easy move for Insanity with the DRS. And, wow, Charlie just lets him throw.
Can you tap the other camera, maybe?
Oh, it's a helicopter shot!
Yes! Yes, the helicopter shot!
Yeah. Finally got it.
Finally.
Homeless says, we call it the daddy of the safety car here in the US. Yes, we do.
Interesting. Ooh, as Joshy boys in.
Four and a half tenths. Ooh, wow. Just had a soft. Looks like maybe he wants to. Oh, Blake's left. So, hopefully no server lag from that. As Joshy comes out P11, he's right behind Sly DJ, so he's not gonna lose out on points, and he will be able to get the fastest lap. Oh no, 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 no! Mel, I did it. I may have done it.
No.
I may have done it.
Oh.
I don't think it'll be a safety car, because the game is being a bit weird.
The game is.
So thankfully, no safety car. AMG does not get his wish, Harmless. Spoke too soon. Oh, my game crashed. It'll be a 5-lap sprint, I think.
Everybody's game crashed?
Sports. It's in the game.
To the rules.
I'm gonna quickly join AMG's party to see if the game can be back in.
Can you make the lobby, Mel?
Yeah, but I'm gonna ask them if their game crashed as well.
I need to clip. Harmless, are you still there? Can you get a clip of the of the final results from before? Oh, what the fuck? Okay, I'm gonna mute. I don't want any of that. I don't really need any of this on the stream. It's not, it's a black screen right now. Is your audio included again?
You do that
I'm gonna
now.
restart my game.
Yeah. They picked up the game, it's
Well,
fully loaded up.
apparently there was a VSC and AMG's tire exploded.
He did say something about himself spinning. Okay, no join.
No! Harmless, that's so.
Okay, you want another fight or you already got one?
I already got one. It's not loading in for me. It's just sitting on a black screen saying, please wait.
I'm gonna join session instead of spectating. It says loaded complete with a with black screen.
Sly
Now,
DJ has left the session.
indeed.
Kairazu has left the session. Did it
This is
crash?
not good.
This is not good at all because we're not in, so I can't see the results.
We need the new lobby. That's fucked. It has success.
We need a new lobby?
The session.
But he's already DNF'd. So I'm confused because if it's just Kairazu who left, so then that doesn't mean anything. Do we need a new lobby? I don't know. This game can go suck a
This is weird as fuck, to say the least.
We're not. I fuck the Bitcoin. Join game. What happens if I don't join as a spectator? You think that'll work?
I tried your idea, but it didn't work.
Says loading complete. I hate this game. Please wait. I'm not restarting. There's no. Do I? Am I gonna have to restart my Xbox? Because one, this is gonna be two streams at that point. And we're gonna lose the final.
I have no clue.
I think I might have to. Wait, what? Is it? I'm confused. Is it fixed? I'm joining AMG's party.
It's good. Pass
Is it
the
working or
site.
no?
It's working for me and
Is the is it?
insanity and then.
It's false. What about all the safety car? Because it's crashed all fucking cars on the main straight.
But I DNF
No,
like
it
10,
yeah,
12 months
DNF
ago.
like 15 laps ago.
Yeah.
I'm confused. So is it working or no?
No.
So.
For the drivers, Kairaza, you DNF'd.
I don't know.
AMG, is it
Apparently,
working?
Gould left as well.
XRX cool left and all that, but
Oh.
I don't know.
I thought you had
Yeah,
the
but he
Gould.
also DNF'd, didn't he?
I don't know
Yeah,
why.
I think so.
Yeah, he did. I
It's
thought he
starting to
had the
rain.
Gould.
I think it's working now.
It's working.
Are you able to? What do you mean you think it's working
It's
now? Is
working.
it? Are
It's
you
working.
racing or no?
We're
Say
not
we're in a
racing.
safety
It's
car.
safety. We have to wait till green flags to
That's still
find
racing.
out.
You're
Yeah,
in lobby.
we're racing. Yeah,
We'll be
we're
on
in
the
the
same
lobby
pitch with
driving.
the safety
I need to
car.
restart my
We're
Xbox.
all
I need to
driving.
restart my Xbox. Okay,
Alright,
I'll do
invite me
that.
if it lets me in.
Fuck.